Hi everyone! In this video, I'm excited to show you how to unlock the power of your Excel data with our Customer Segmentation Dashboard in PowerBI. Let's dive in! This ready-to-use template will transform your Excel data into actionable insights, allowing you to segment customers and make informed business decisions effortlessly. Let's take a quick tour of the dashboard and its features. Right at the top, there is a drop-down selector for the fiscal year, allowing you to easily toggle to the period of interest. On the left side, we have two KPI cards displaying the total customer count and sales for the selected fiscal year. These cards also include year-on-year variances and mini bar charts showing the last 6 months' pattern, giving you a quick sense of how your organization is performing. Next to the KPI cards, there's a line chart showing the monthly sales trend for the selected fiscal year and the prior year. This chart helps you quickly identify sales patterns and trends over time, allowing you to make data-driven decisions. Below the KPI card, we have a map that visualizes the number of customers in different countries using bubble size. You can click on any country to filter the entire dashboard for that specific country, providing a geographic breakdown of your customer base. Beside the map, there are two charts designed for deep customer segmentation analysis. There's a drop-down list that allows you to choose which segment you want to drill into, be it age group, income group, or shopping method. The first chart is a tree map that shows the number of customers by the selected customer segmentation. This provides a quick overview of where your majority customers are concentrated, whether it's age 30 to 39 group, age 40 to 49 group, or specific income groups, or their preferred shopping method, such as physical outlets, website, or mobile. The second chart is a box plot that displays sales by the selected customer segmentation. It highlights the highest, lowest, and average sales for each segment. For example, you can see the highest sales from customers in their 30s, or the average sales from those in their 20s. This chart is particularly useful for understanding the distribution of sales across different customer segments and identifying key opportunities. The best part? This dashboard provides these insights with just a customer data table and a sales data table. If you like what you're seeing so far, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, let's talk about how you can turn this dashboard into your own in three simple steps. Step 1. Download the template. Head over to the link in the description to download the PowerBI template and the Excel dataset. It's completely free and easy to access. You will find two files at the drive, the PowerBI file for the dashboard, and an Excel file containing the sample dataset. After downloading, extract them from the zip file as shown, and we are done with step 1. Step 2. Replace the dataset. Before we dive into the dataset, let's go over a high-level overview of the data structure. For this customer segmentation analysis, we'll be examining customer data to understand sales patterns across different segments. The data comes from two main tables, the customer data table and the sales table. These are standard datasets that most organizations maintain, though they might not fully realize the valuable insights they contain. These tables are linked by the customer ID field. Additionally, we've included a country table to enhance the dashboard's functionality, allowing users to easily filter data for country-specific reviews. As you can see, with just these three simple Excel tables, the dashboard can transform your data into actionable insights. All right, let's open the Excel file. We will start with the fiscal year setup. In the first worksheet, Parameters, you just need to select the start month of your reporting period from the drop-down list. The file will automatically populate the fiscal end month below. The end month number highlighted in green is required to update the BI file later. The next worksheet, Sales, contains the sales data. It includes sales ID, sales date, mode of purchase ID, customer ID, product ID, quantity purchased, unit price, total sales, discount, and net sales amount, which is total sales minus discount. These are fundamental sales information. Replace the sample data with your own sales data. Next, the customer's worksheet contains customer information, including fields such as customer ID, customer name, birthday, income ID, country ID, and membership join date. Replace these sample data with your own customer details. The final worksheet, country, includes information on the countries where your organization conducts sales. This table enables the dashboard to offer a country-specific view of your data. Update this worksheet with your organization's regional data accordingly. With this, we are done with the Excel file. Step 3. Load your data to the BI template. Open the BI file in the Power BI desktop. If you don't have Power BI desktop yet, download it free from the Microsoft website. The link is in the description. For those interested in creating the box plot shown on the dashboard, I have made a time-lapse video. Click the link above to watch. Back to replacing the data file in Power BI, click on the Transform Data button to enter the query view. To adjust the data source settings, click on the Data Source Settings button at the top. Select the file shown and click on Change Source. Now press Browse and navigate to the folder where you saved your dataset. The BI file will auto-update the data from the new file. While still in the query view, update the reporting period. Click on Dim Date on the left side of the screen, then under the Applied Steps on the right side, click on Fiscal Year and Month. You will see 3, as this template was set up for the reporting period from April to March month. Replace it with your end month number by clicking on the bar, typing in your number, and press Enter. Once you are done, click on the last line under the Applied Steps. To exit the query view and load the data, go to the top left corner and click Close and Apply. The BI file will start loading your data, so give it some time. And that's it. By following these simple steps, you'll have a fully functional customer segmentation dashboard that you can use to analyze and visualize your customer data, identifying key trends and opportunities. Everything is already set up. Going forward, you just need to update the Excel worksheet and click the refresh button at the top to update the dashboard. I hope you like this customer dashboard template for your work or learning. For those looking for dashboards to track staff attrition or sales opportunity, check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.